Hey folks, today I want to show you my new old drill press here. It's built in year 1967, so it is over 50 years old. And of course it has developed some problems now. For example, the grill doesn't move smoothly. This has to be fixed. But it is working, so I have already drilled something with it and it's really comfortable compared to my cheap drill press to work with it, even with the stuck grill here. And this video series will be about the restoration of this drill press, and the topic of today's video is just an introduction, and I want to show you all the features the drill press has and what problems it has. So let's have a closer look. First, I want to show you some chips. Here an M8 countersink for an M8 flathead screw. Drilling with 4.5 mm. And 13 mm, but this drill isn't really high quality. I also did a quick runout test on the spindle. I wasn't quite sure with this 500 mm runout here. But when I mounted the drill chuck and measured down there, I only had 0.03 mm on the shank of the tool. So I think that's not super good, but good enough for now. Let's look inside. Here you can see the main feature I definitely wanted for my new drill press, and that's this continuous variable transmission here. So you can change the RPM of the spindle whatever you want, from the minimum to the maximum. Well, I think I just demonstrated now. Lowest speed. Highest speed. The advantage of this CVT is when you have half the RPM on this spindle pulley here than the motor pulley, you have double the torque. And if you reduce the RPM with a variable frequency drive, then you will always have the same torque regardless of RPM. Maybe when you go to really low RPM, the torque will also drop, but normally you have about the same torque over the whole RPM range. So with this you have much more torque for drilling with big diameter drills. I will combine both worlds, the CVT and a variable frequency drive I have over here. So I can use the CVT for normal work when I want to have the higher torque. And if I want to go even lower than the 125 RPM, I can just use the VFD to go lower for thread cutting or something like that. And I also can monitor the motor current and limit the power of the motor and so on with the VFD. So just have much more possibilities than without. Let's have a look at the lower part of the drill press. Here's nothing special, a heavy cast iron table, so you won't have to worry about vibration caused by a light machine here. And the distance from the drill chuck to the table is in the most upper position here, 250 millimeters. And let's crank it down to the lowest position. As you can see, it goes down quite a lot, and it's only about 40 millimeters from the drill chuck to the table, so I don't really know why it goes down so far. And that's another thing I want to change. You have seen the column here in the back. I want to make a little extender piece so the whole head of the drilling machine comes up a little bit. And so I will get more distance in the lowest position, but also more distance in the highest position when I have to drill something thick or something like that. I can also do it on this machine. And maybe I also will make a longer extension if I have to drill something very big. That's only 4 screws I have to unscrew. And I think that's quite easy to put the extension piece in here, but you will see that in more detail when I disassemble the machine. This drill press has a Morse taper 2 in the spindle, and to remove the drill chuck or anything else you have in the spindle, just extend the grill a little bit, push in this knob here, and then turn the grill up, and the drill chuck or anything else will come out. Let's have a look at the other side. There isn't really much to see, just the lock for the head position and the lever for the CVT. Here on the lever are marks for the RPM, but I won't really use this when the machine is finished. I think I will add a digital RPM display here in the front, and also the display for the grill extension digital, so working will be easier. And also when I use the variable frequency drive, these numbers won't be right anymore, so I won't hassle with that. Just adding a display with the actual RPM of the spindle, and then it's, you know exactly how fast the spindle turns. I think that's enough for an overview now. Let's come to the problems I have found on this machine here. One is really obviously, that's the paint. It definitely needs some new paint, especially the base is really bad. The top section here is already painted with this gray color. The pre-owner did this. He also wanted to restore this drill press here, but he got another one, so he sold this in the middle of the restoration. He also changed all the bearings, so I don't have to do that. But there are still enough problems left to do, so it won't be boring for me. Here's another thing the pre-owner already did. He added this pulley and V-belt here to drive the machine. Originally, it's driven by this pinion here, and that's really, really loud and has a ugly screaming noise. And with this belt here, the machine should get a lot quieter. So I maybe will finish this belt drive system here. It's not completely finished, so I change to the original motor and pinion here just to dry the drill press a little bit. And here's another problem of the machine. You can see the belt of the CVT here. The tension is right now, but when I change the CVT to 1:1 gear ratio about, then you will see what happened. Now the belt is very loose. So tension it now would just result in too much tension when I go to the end of the CVT adjustment. But I also have the reason for this problem. The pre-owner has a spare part left when he has disassembled and reassembled the machine. And this part fits exactly the diameter of the bearings used in the CVT system. So I think when I put this in again, this problem should be solved. And it's also not really so a big problem because the tension of the belt here is still enough that it can transmit power. But I think it would be better when the tension is nearly the same over the whole CVT adjustment. There's one very important problem to solve, and that's the little bit stuck quill here. As you can see, when I lower the quill and don't touch the handle anymore, the quill does not go up again. But I noticed already one thing. When I lower the quill completely, it does return a little bit. I already checked the surface of the quill here. I can't see any scratch marks or something like that that could cause this. So I have to further investigate where the problem is. And here you can see the problem that caused most of the stuck quill. That's the spindle shaft here. The view is from the top on the main spindle shaft. As you can see, this turns when the machine is on, but also has to move down when the quill is lowered. And the pre-owner made a new spindle shaft, and he already told me that the shaft is a little bit too tight up here. So let's see, maybe I have to grind away a little bit of the outer diameter and widen the keyway a little bit. Then this problem should be solved, but it's not the whole problem of the stuck quill. You will see later that the quill is still a little bit stuck when I remove this pulley here. One thing I will make completely new is the electric of the drill press. This here is the old system, just a big switch for the motor with the 2 RPM and a fuse for the motor, and an extension rod for the switch so you can switch it from the front of the machine. But I really don't like that, and I will make that completely new. How it will exactly look like, I don't know yet, but it's also not so important. First, I want to make the mechanic work flawless, and after that I can think about the electric system. That were all the problems I found so far. So let's end the video here, and in the next part I will show you the disassembling, and maybe we will already have a closer look at the stuck quill, because that's the first thing I will repair. And yeah, I hope you liked the video and you will like this project also. If that's the case, please give a thumbs up and subscribe. Don't forget to activate the bell so you get notified if I post a new video, and see you next time.